The previous class we did radiation resistance of short electric dipole. This is very important for your internal test as well as the examination point of view. So radiation resistance of short electric dipole means that is the fictitious resist. What is radiation resistance? Just to recap the definition which we read in module 3. Resistance when connected in series with the antenna, it is a fictitious resistance when connected in series with the antenna will consume the same power as actually radiated by the antenna. That is your definition of radiation resistance. Fictitious resistance when connected with series with the antenna will consume the same power as is actually radiated by the antenna. So that is the definition of radiation resistance. So any antenna for that matter will have a radiation resistance. So if you have to design an intraterrestrial antenna or intrasteral antenna or for your communication for interspace communication, all these things you need to find out the radiation resistance. So that is the most important thing. Here it is a simple dipole antenna, so you will have more complex shapes and sizes of the antenna for which you have to find the radiation resistance. There are some modeling tools and softwares to find it to make your life simpler. But in general, you should know the concept of how it is done, whichever software you may use. Is my screen visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think Saurav and Bina missed the previous class. I'll just go through what we have done. Otherwise, you won't be able to follow this one. Okay. There's a big derivation. Don't get afraid with the size of the derivation. So in this finding out this radiation resistance of the short electric dipole, what we do is we equate the actual power which is supplied to the antenna to the actual power which is radiated by the antenna. When you equate these two, you will get the radiation resistance. Actual power supplied to the antenna is through electrical circuit. So that is given by I square RMS into radiation resistance. And that is equal to the actual power radiated by the antenna. The actual power radiated by the antenna, that is into free space. So you don't have an electrical circuit there. It will be defined by field theory or electromagnetic wave theory by what is known as a pointing theorem, which will equate your power radiated into free space by doing the double integration of the pointing vector, radial component of the pointing vector over the entire surface. Okay, just to tell you what is this doing, if you're able to see my screen and video, so you have to find power radiated in free space here. This surface you have to integrate this surface here. So that will be a double integration, and we'll only consider the radial component of pointing vector, because the change with respect to radius for the theta and the phi component is negligible. So it does not change with respect to the radial component. So therefore, we consider only the radial component of the pointing vector. Anyway, to start the derivation, we'll have the average pointing vector, which is given by half of real component of E cross H conjugate. The radial component of the pointing vector is given by half of real part of E theta H phi conjugate. So E theta by H phi is nothing but the intrinsic impedance of the free space, that is your 120 pi. So E theta can be written as H phi into Z. So radial component of pointing vector, that is if you substitute equation 3 in 2, so you will get the radial component of pointing vector as half of real part of H phi conjugate into Z, that is half of H phi square into real part of the Z component, or it can be rewritten as half of H phi square root of mu by epsilon. This component Z, what we are talking, this is your intrinsic impedance. Intrinsic impedance, and this is equal to 120 pi for free space. Free space means vacuum. Okay, agreed. This is your vacuum. And this is all, if it is vacuum, it is given by mu naught by epsilon naught. In the medium, what it will be there, you multiplied by mu r epsilon r will come. Okay. to find the total power radiated, we integrate this radial component of the pointing vector over the entire surface of d theta d phi. So I'll integrate this phi varying from 0 to 2 pi, theta varying from 0 to pi, h phi square r square sine theta d phi. Substitute h phi is equal to I naught beta l, that is magnitude of h phi is I naught beta l 4 pi r sine theta. This is what is the derivation we did for fields of a short electric dipole. If you remember this, just see this equation, I naught beta j I naught beta l 4 pi r sine theta e raised to the power j omega t minus r by c. Take this modulus value. So modulus value will get I naught beta l by 4 pi r sine theta. So h phi square is equal to I naught square beta square l square divided 4 pi square r square into sine square theta. So that one you substitute for power radiated. After all this mathematical manipulation, you will get power radiated is equal to mu naught by epsilon naught I naught square beta square l square by 12 pi. Call that as equation 5. Assuming no loss, the power streaming out of the sphere is equal to the power delivered to the dipole. That is what I told you. So equate this equation number 5 to the RMS value of the power radiated. That is I square RMS into radiation resistance. I square RMS, this I RMS is nothing but I naught by root 2. So I square RMS will be this one square. So that is what I have equated. Find out the radiation resistance. If you substitute everything, beta is equal to substitute as 2 pi by lambda. And after all this mathematical calculation, you will get the radiation resistance of short dipole as 80 pi square L by lambda whole square. So this is your radiation resistance of your short electric dipole. Is it clear? Any doubts on this derivation? One quick recap I did of this. Anything you would like to ask before I proceed for the radiation resistance of the lambda by 2 dipole antenna? Please tell me, any doubts?
No, sir, no doubts.
So next derivation, what we did is finding out, please remember, radiation resistance of short dipole is different and fields of the short dipole is different. Do not get confused between them. One, you have to find the electric field. Another, you have to find the radiation resistance. And both are important derivations. Okay. Now the third important derivation in your module 4B is radiation resistance of lambda by 2 dipole antenna, are also known as the half wave dipole antenna. This is also known as half wave lambda by 2. What is lambda? It is nothing but the wavelength. So wavelength by 2 dipole antenna they will call lambda by 2 dipole antenna or half wave dipole antenna. So both the nomenclature is same, radiation resistance of lambda by 2 dipole antenna or half wave dipole antenna. So to find the radiation resistance of lambda by 2 dipole antenna or half wave dipole, same thing you take, start from the same pointing theorem. S is equal to that is nothing but your pointing vector. S is equal to half of real part of E cross H conjugate. Since S theta and S phi are equal to 0 because they do not change with respect to radius, the component S theta and S phi. So the rate of change is 0. Therefore, we consider only the radial component of the pointing vector. So the radial component of pointing vector is given by half of real part of E theta H phi conjugate. Then E theta is equal to H phi into Z. So E theta is equal to H phi. Z is nothing but mu naught epsilon naught. So substituting equation 3 in 2, you will get radial component of pointing vector as half of real part of h phi square into mu naught by epsilon naught. So the power radiated is nothing but same thing, surface integral of radial component of pointing vector into ds. Till this point, the derivation for the short electric dipole as well as lambda by 2 dipole antenna or half wave dipole antenna is exactly same. Till this your equation number 4, your derivation for short electric dipole as well as half wave dipole antenna is exactly same. I'm repeating up to radial component of pointing vector and the power radiated equation, both the derivation steps are same. So one you study, it will mimic the other. Now where the change come is the value of h of I. When I am putting, I'll put as cos of, okay, this is where is the change coming. So I'll just let you know. So can you see this equation? Can you see that equation, all of you? Okay, fine. See, what you have to substitute here is H phi. This is what we are substituting here, no? Here H phi. You have to substitute as cos of beta L cos theta by 2 minus cos of beta L by 2. So this is what you need to substitute for this value of h of phi. So got it? This is the what you need to substitute. All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is what you need to substitute here. Now, this is the exact equation of H of phi. For doing problems, okay, sorry, there is I naught by 2 pi r. I forgot to write that. I naught by 2 pi r. For doing problems, this is approximated as I naught by 2 pi r, I naught by 2 pi r cos of pi by 2 cos of theta. Okay, this is whole divided by sin theta, sorry. Okay, I'll rewrite in a new page so that you won't get confused. For lambda by 2 dipole antenna or half wave dipole antenna, what you should write H of phi as is what I'm going to write now. So please get this concept absolutely clear. That page is little clumsy, therefore I'm rewriting this equation here. Can you all see the screen? Can you all see the screen? Okay. I naught by 2 pi r cos of beta L cos theta by 2 cos of beta L cos theta by 2 minus, this is inside the bracket itself, cos of beta L by 2, this whole divided by sin theta. This is the exact value of H of phi which I have substituted here. Cos of beta L cos theta by 2 minus cos beta L by 2 sin theta into I naught by 2 pi r. So this is your modulus value of H of phi. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Bina, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Purva Chandra Prakash, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Who else is there? Rainak Sharma, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank you. Okay. Now, this is your exact value, and this you need to remember. Okay. Now, not so exact value, which you need to be used for problems, for problems is H of I is equal to, please write down this equation. This is an approximation for doing for problems because you can't use the above equation. I naught by 2 pi r cos of, again within bracket, pi by 2 cos theta divided by sine theta. Okay. Now this equation is to be used for doing problems. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So I have used the exact equation and done the derivation. In the notes, they have used the approximate equation. Both are correct. Use whichever is fine. Anyway, if I use the exact equation, you will do some more mathematical steps. And please remember, this equation is only for the half wave dipole. If you are using the short dipole, if the problem is for short dipole, you have to use I naught beta l sine theta by 4 pi r. I naught beta l sine theta by 4 pi r. This equation you have to use. I naught beta l divided by 4 pi r into sine theta. This is what you are required to use. Okay, so where was I? Just go through this derivation. I'll be back with you shortly. Okay. Is it clear? All
Yes, sir.
Any doubts? Okay. So if it is short dipole, what you will use Mahima equation for short dipole?
Sir, I naught square beta square L square divided by 4 pi square R square sine square theta.
That is H phi square, ma, if it is only H phi.
I naught beta L divided by 4 pi R into sine theta.
Very good. Okay. Okay. So if short dipole, if short dipole, you can use I naught beta L. Please tell me. Divided
by 4 pi r into sine theta.
Sine theta in the numerator, right?
Yes, sir.
This is your value of h of pi for short dipole. Because all these are we are using for the problem. That is why I am repeating and rewriting it 101 times. So what I have done is from this radiation resistance equation, I have found the power radiated I square RMS into radiation resistance. I have equated that to that. So after equating, you will get some this one. Then you have to tell this as equivalent to sine integral. It may be shown that the radiation resistance of the lambda by 2 dipole antenna is 13 cosine integral of 2 pi, and that the cosine integral of 2 pi is nothing but 2.44. So this cosine integral of 2 pi is approximately equal to 2.44. So radiation resistance of lambda by 2 dipole antenna can be shown as equal to 73 ohms. Okay. Now this derivation, what I have done here is as per John D. Cross, your prescribed textbook. Okay. There we where he has used the exact equation and done this derivation. If you want to use some other method, which is also available in the notes, that is up to you. I have done an exact derivation. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So the recording of this derivation is already there in your previous class. So then we also started to do some problems on this. Some of the problems are very easy. Some I would like to do it and show to you. Beena, is it clear? You had missed the previous class.
Yes, sir. It's clear, sir.
Okay. See, my only aim is all of you should be able to do well in this, not only in exam, in life also. See, there are around 120 students in the class right now, around 25 are attending. So out of this, around 5 to 10, if they are interested and they go, some of you go on to join the Indian Space Research Organization, that is the biggest national service that I can do or you can do. Or some people will have a greater ambition. You want to go and join NASA and work. That is the biggest contribution you can do for the scientific community. So please keep a bigger aim in picture while you are studying for any examination. Especially subjects which are of high scientific and technological interest, like microwave and antenna or anything of that. Even digital signal processing, electromagnetic field have tremendous applications. So whatever it is, when you are strong in your fundamentals and you are strong in the subject, you can go, sky is the limit. I'm telling you, from minus infinity to plus infinity is the limit. Sky is the limit for you if you know the concepts. You can go on to become a very big person. You can go on to become much bigger person than what I am presently. I set a goals for achieving something in the life, and at least some 10% of that I could be able to achieve. And I hope I still have aims in life. I have not stopped at this. So have some aim, try to achieve that. See, now Kalpana Chawla, everybody remembers. Each one of you know her, right? Who is Kalpana Chawla?
Yes, sir.
Okay. She lost her life for the scientific community, and she is an Indian origin, worked in NASA. Everybody knows her. See, even one school children, you ask, they may know her. So this is what one of our motivational speaker used to tell. They will immediately ask you suddenly, who is the CEO of Infosys? Can you tell? Okay. CEO of Mindtree, can you tell? We won't be able to recollect immediately. Moment you tell Kalpana Chawla, everybody knows. Moment you tell CNR Rao, everybody knows. Because they have achieved something and it has been globally and socially recognizable. So that is what you need to go and achieve, and so that you will become famous and you can contribute to the society. That should be your goal. Am I right, Wing Commander Rao? All of you are able to hear me loud and clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So I'll just go on to do the recap of the this one. Same thing he has written. Formula: radiation resistance for short dipole is 80 pi square L by lambda whole square. Short dipole means length of the antenna should be lesser than lambda by 4. Radiation resistance of a half wave dipole is given as 73 ohms. And for a short dipole, substitute H phi is equal to I naught beta L divided 2 pi r sin theta. This is what I have written here. 1 minute. This is what I have written here. Okay. I naught beta L 4 pi r sin theta. That is what you have to substitute for short dipole. For lambda by 2 dipole, substitute H phi is equal to I naught 2 pi r cos of pi by 2 cos theta by sin theta, and E theta by H phi is 120 pi. And your power radiated is I naught square root 2 square or I naught square 2 into radiation resistance, and radiation efficiency you already know. This problem we did a thin linear antenna of lambda by 10 long. If its loss resistance is 2.5 ohms, find the radiation resistance and efficiency. Given L is equal to lambda by 10, so this is lesser than, it is smaller than lambda by 4. So which formula you have to apply? Short dipole radiation resistance formula. So direct substitution, you will get radiation resistance as 7.89 ohms when you substitute L is equal to lambda by 10. Efficiency is nothing but radiation resistance plus radiation resistance plus radiation resistance plus loss resistance. Efficiency you get as equal to 75.93 ohms. Okay. Okay, next question is, do you want me to solve the question or shall I read out like this? I'm asking you a question. Do I solve the question or read out? Purva Chandra Prakash, please tell me what I should do.
Sir, already we have done now, sir. Just read.
Okay, good. No, some were absent. No, just one small recap. Okay, good. At least you gave me one solution. Okay, magnetic field strength of 20 microampere per meter is required to be produced at a point 2.5 kilometer. Radius is 2.5 kilometer. This is your magnetic field strength. Hertzian dipole means half wave dipole, Hertzian dipole, half wave dipole. Hertzian dipole means short dipole, half wave dipole, monopole, quarter wave antenna. So power radiated is nothing but I square by 2 into radiation resistance. H of I is given, radius is given. For a broadside, theta is equal to 90 degree. For a Hertzian dipole with L is equal to lambda by this one, put short dipole antenna formula, you will find the radiation resistance. Then H of I is given. Then H of I is given, substitute for the formula for Hertzian dipole, that is short dipole, I naught into this same equation. I naught beta L sin theta divided by 4 pi r. Beta is nothing but 2 pi by r. Sorry, 2 pi by lambda. So if you do that, then they have found the value of I naught, then found the power radiated. For a half wave dipole, substitute H of I is equal to I naught by 2 pi r cos of pi by 2 cos theta by sin theta. For theta is equal to 90 degrees, substitute that and you will get the power radiated. For a quarter wave monopole antenna, whatever is the power radiated by half wave dipole divided by 2, you will get the power radiated for a quarter wave monopole antenna. Clear? So the last topic in your module 4 last topic for your module 4 is thin linear antenna, and I'll just show you the syllabus. So what we have done is introduction, short electric dipole, fields of a short electric dipole, general and far field analysis, radiation resistance of a short dipole, thin linear antenna, radiation resistance of a lambda by 2 antenna. So what is left is thin linear antenna. So that is what is left. Any doubts still here?
No, sir.
In linear antenna. This is the last topic of your module 4. Please write 1 minute. Okay. And just see if there is any notes regarding thin linear antenna so that your work will be easier. Please take down this statement. Thin linear antenna. If the diameter of the conductor used for the antenna is very much lesser than lambda by 100, then such antennas are called as thin linear antenna. That is, your diameter is less than 100 and length of the antenna should be greater than or equal to lambda by 4. Whereas the diameter is far, far lesser than lambda by 100. So this is what is a thin linear antenna. That is not sufficient. You have to continue with that. So whatever is the definition given in the notes, you continue, because it will come as a short nose question for a 6 months question sometimes. So write on. In case of thin linear antenna, the following assumptions are made. Antenna are symmetrical and fed at the center and they are balanced by the two wire transmission line. Okay. By two wire transmission line, antenna may be of any length. Is my handwriting clear?
Yes, sir.
Of any length, but it is assumed that the current distribution is sinusoidal, is sinusoidal and diameter is far far lesser than lambda by 100. Diameter is far far lesser than lambda by 100. Lambda by 100. I'm thinking how to draw this diagram. Okay, we will see. This length is lambda by 2 antenna. This is how the current distribution will come. Next I will draw is, these are some of the examples of your thin linear antenna. Your lambda by 2 is also one of the thin linear antennas, but it has a separate derivation. You won't get problems on thin linear antenna, only write short notes on thin linear antenna. Mahima, enter the class, tell me what is the portion you want for the third test from my antenna side. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is your 3/4 lambda. This is the length of the antenna, 3/4. Then your current distribution comes like this. Yeah. Now you will get more interesting current distributions. This is not waveform, okay? Current distribution waveform. That is how your current distribution will end up coming. This is your 5/4 lambda. 5/4 lambda. Sorry. This is 2 lambda. Lambda. This is your current distribution. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please continue. The retarded value of current at any point Z referred to a point at a distance S is given by I is equal to I naught sine of 2 pi by lambda L by 2 plus minus Z into e raised to the power j omega t minus R by C. Okay. This is your current equation for your short dipole, thin linear, and write down the term sine of 2 pi by lambda L by 2 plus minus Z is known as form factor for the currents on the antenna. Clear? Okay. The term L by 2 plus Z is used when Z is less than equal to 0 and the term L by 2 minus Z is used when Z is greater than 0. Okay. Thin linear antenna. Okay. Can be made up of series of infinitely small dipole of length PZ. The fields of the center antenna is obtained by integrating the fields from all the dipoles making the antenna. I think till here, if you do, it is more than sufficient. I don't think they will ask beyond this. Okay, let me finish. There's one more sentence. It may be shown that. It may be shown that the far field far fields of a thin linear center fed antenna of length L can be written as H of phi is equal to J I naught divided by 2 pi R cos of beta L cos theta by 2 minus cos beta L by 2. This is nothing but your lambda by 2 dipole antenna, same equation, one extra J term is coming for you because we are not taking the modulus value, remember? Okay, then E theta is equal to J 60 I naught by R cos of same thing beta L cos theta by 2 minus cos of beta L by 2 whole divided by sin theta. Okay. E theta is equal to Z into H phi. This already you know. So E theta is equal to 120 into H. That ends your thin linear antenna. So that ends your module number 4. Anything you want to ask? Anything you would like to ask? Yes, Bina, anything you would like to ask for module 4 over?
No, sir. The test portion, sir.
Test portions. Suggest me. Third test portions from antenna side. Suggest me. Mahima.
Sir, up to concepts which you learned today, can those be included for third internal, sir?
That is what I am asking you. No, from where to where? Till today is okay. Test portions, you tell me now.
Sir, after second internal, from the topic which we started, sir, retarded current.
Okay, so I'll write portions for the third IA test. Portions for third IA test antenna side. Okay, only antenna. Microwave ask wing commander. Okay, so first one. Problems on radiation pattern plotting. Radiation pattern plotting. Agreed. This one we have done. Remember?
Yes, sir.
These things. Okay. These things we have done on 6th January. 4 point sources are placed, 11 by the power is applied with equal amplitude phase difference. All this, how do you plot? So how do you do radiation pattern plotting? So I have done a lot of problems on this. Yeah. I think this was the portions for the second test. So this is what after second test we have done. Next. This fields of short electric dipole derivation. Fields of short electric dipole derivation. Next, radiation resistance of short electrical dipole, short electric dipole derivation. Yeah. Next, radiation resistance of lambda by 2 dipole. This you have to prove as equal to 73 ohms derivation. Okay. Problems on short electric dipole and lambda by 2 dipole. Next, thin linear antenna. So this is the portions. Anything you want change? Any change? Yes, Mahima, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Ibina, is it okay?
Yes, sir.